After more than a year of pandemic-led chaos, cruising is set to resume across the UK, Europe, and the Caribbean this year. Many brand new ships that have yet to welcome any paying guests on board will finally get to undertake their maiden voyages. Let's start with one of the most notable new ships of this decade so far, Scarlet Lady. The first of three 110,000-ton ships for the brand new Virgin Voyages, the ship was ready for service in early 2020 and actually undertook several shakedown cruises with media, press, and travel agents on board. However, after repositioning to the Caribbean, the pandemic-led cruise shutdown saw Scarlet Lady skip her maiden voyage, and she's remained laid up ever since, having sailed back to the shipyard in Italy to ride out the pandemic. Scarlet Lady will finally enter passenger service in August, undertaking cruises from the British port of Portsmouth. Six cruises of between 2 to 4 nights are on offer, before the ship finally makes her way to her permanent home port in the Caribbean. Another large ship that has been waiting for her first guests is Celebrity Apex. The second in the Edge class of 130,000-ton ships, Apex was handed over in a virtual ceremony to Celebrity in spring of 2020, which for those of us south of the equator was autumn last year, so right about the time when the pandemic was really beginning to impact cruising. Having sailed to the Caribbean to wait out the cruise pause with some of her fleet mates, the ship will return to Europe and commence its first cruises from Athens in June. P&O's Iona will also make her first voyage with passengers this year, after having several of her planned maiden voyages cancelled since she was built. The ship is the largest ever to sail for P&O Cruises, and is currently due to cruise from August with her maiden voyage sailing to Scotland's Iona Island, where she will anchor off the coast and offer views of her namesake. This voyage, and most of the other P&O early cruise voyages, will have no port calls. Royal Caribbean's brand new Odyssey of the Seas will make her first passenger voyage in Israel with cruises from 3 to 7 nights. Cruises aboard the Quantum-class ship will sail from Haifa to the Greek Isles and are open to Israeli guests and only those who are vaccinated. Saga's much-anticipated Spirit of Adventure will soon make her first passenger cruise with the ship set to depart from Tilbury in July for a 15-night voyage around the UK. Spirit of Adventure is a near-identical sister ship to the 2009-built Spirit of Discovery, both of which clock in at just over 58,000 tons, making them noticeably larger than the retired Saga ships they have replaced. MSC's Virtuosa will also make her debut in UK waters, with the 181,000-ton ship now heading to Southampton from France's Chantier de l'Antique shipyard, where she was built. From Southampton, she will make her maiden voyage and undertake a series of UK-based cruises with British-only passengers on board. There are several other new cruise ships set to debut in 2021, including the much-anticipated Mardi Gras and Enchanted Princess. However, ongoing issues with the US's CDC cruise ban has led to the start dates of several cruises being moved around. There is lots of activity that will be required to get these cruise ships back into service, from recrewing and reprovisioning them to testing that all the lights and power points work. You can actually check out all the details in a video I made about restarting the cruise ships, which is in the info card or the description below. While it is a huge job to return the cruise ships to service, it's not insurmountable. During World War I and World War II, many new ocean liners were requisitioned into military and trooping roles before they ever saw a fare-paying passenger. This includes some of the most famous ships of all time, such as Cunard's Queen Elizabeth. And these ships had massive wartime conversions, which took months to undo before they could finally make their maiden passenger voyages. So while 2021 will be hard for cruise lines, it's not unprecedented. Thanks so much for watching, and I hope you found the video interesting. If you did, please don't forget to give it a like and share and subscribe so that you can see future videos. Thanks once again for watching, and when it is safe for us to all set sail again, I hope to see you on board.